I'd like to announce that the government yesterday approved the establishment of a new further education and training authority called Solas, which is the educational and further learning and skills services. The current separation of the further education and training sectors is, in my view, an obstacle to the delivery of a 21st century service to job seekers and learners. That is why Solas will be a new organisation with a new mandate which merges the further education and training sectors. This represents possibly the most significant change in further education in over 70 years and the most significant change in the training sector since the establishment of FOSS itself over 20 years ago. The new Solas mandate would be to ensure that further education and training programmes provide job seekers and other learners with the new skills needed for today's 21st century jobs market. Solas will ensure that there is a greater focus on skills provision for occupations in growth areas like services, ICT, medical devices, food and biopharma sectors. This will mean less skills provision for jobs in the traditional construction and manufacturing sectors. These new programmes under Solas will be integrated, flexible, value-friendly and responsive to the needs of learners and the requirements of a changed and changing economy. Solas will also ensure that further education and training courses are provided in new ways that are more appropriate to the current digital age and more efficient in terms of the use of resources. In particular, it will significantly expand the online, blended and even provision, evening provision of further education and training courses. Solas will be underpinned by stronger quality assurance, occupational standards, international benchmarks and course content reviews. Solas will ensure that the further education sector will play a more significant role in the activation of the unemployed through its inclusion in the National Employment Action Plan referral process as implemented by the Department of Social Protection. The Solas Implementation Group will be established and chaired by Kieran Cannon, Minister for State with responsibility for training and skills to deliver on these new arrangements. FOSS will be disbanded and replaced with a new agency, Solas. The employment services and the employment programme functions of FOSS are currently being transferred to the Department of Social Protection. Solas will initially take responsibility for all FOSS staff and premises not transferring to that department. Over time, FOSS training centre staff and premises will be transferred to the vocational education committees. And these 33 committees at present will, under a separate initiative which I've undertaken, will be consolidated and reduced to 16 vocational education committees across the country. This means that ultimately the VECs, under the strategic direction of Solas, will be responsible for the integrated delivery of both further education and training services to the public. In addition, I propose to invite the existing members of the FOSS board to continue to serve out their current terms as members of the Solas board once the relevant legislation has been passed. I would like to thank them for their efforts in helping FOSS to play an important role in our response to unemployment and to say that their knowledge and experience will be invaluable as we transition to the new arrangements. FOSS will be renamed as Solas on an administrative basis as quickly as possible and in advance of the passing of the relevant legislation by the office. I do want to emphasise one point very strongly. This announcement is not in any way to cast aspersions on the good and important work that the current FOSS board, the VEC committee members and the FOSS and VEC staff have done in recent times. Indeed, Solas will provide these staff with a new overarching management structure and the strategic direction that they need to allow their work on the ground to have a greater impact so that the job seekers and learners get the right skills to progress their education and get back into employment. Kieran.
Thank you, Minister. The decision by the government to integrate the further education and training sector is a major step forward in the development of a strategic national response across these two sectors. The establishment of the new authority called Solas will help ensure that we meet the twin challenges of reskilling our job seekers so that we can get back into employment and at the same time upskill our learners to meet the objectives of the National Skills Strategy. The plan to integrate the training and further education provision of the department has also been closely aligned to the recently announced decision by the government to reduce the number of VECs from 33 down to 16. I will chair the Solas Implementation Group, which has been tasked with ensuring the delivery of these new arrangements, and the membership of the Implementation Group will include the Department of Education and Skills, FOSS and the Irish Vocational Education Association, and it will also consult with other stakeholders as appropriate. The immediate task for this group will be to develop an action plan which will implement these changes and report progress to the Cabinet Committee on Economic Recovery and Jobs in the autumn. In the new arrangements, the Department of Education and Skills and the government will define the broad strategy and national priorities, decide on the funding level, develop the legislative framework and oversee the implementation. Solas, for its part, will implement the policies and strategies in the further education and training sector and will be accountable in that regard with reference to agreed performance indicators. With the assistance of the Experts Group for Future Skills Needs, it will analyse and forecast demand for further education and training provision. Solas will allow for the creation of a single one-stop-shop entry point for potential further education and training participants and will allow for their referral to the most appropriate course, whether in further education or training. It will have a single, coherent, national management structure to drive the implementation of the changes necessary to ensure the delivery of a quality, modern and relevant further education and training service to learners. For the first time, in cooperation with the Department of Social Protection's National Employment Action Plan, those on the live register will be systematically referred to further education programmes. The intention is that over a period beginning with the 2012 estimates, Solas will receive an increasing proportion of the financial allocation for further education and training services from the Department of Education and Skills. Solas will in turn enter into annual service level agreements with the VECs, SkillNets and other bodies for the delivery of specific further education and training programmes for specified financial allocations. These new arrangements will require the Labour Services Acts to be amended to facilitate the renaming and the remandating of FOSS, and to ensure legal certainty will involve amendment of the Vocational Education Act and the Education Acts to facilitate the VECs taking over responsibility for the provision of training services in addition to their existing further education responsibilities. Solas will, over time, reduce costs through lower administration costs and the elimination of programme duplication after appropriate reviews have been completed. It will have an increased focus on outputs and outcomes, especially in the further education sector, and this will lead to greater value for money at a time of significantly increased demand for further education and training supports. I look forward to working with the Solas Board and management and other stakeholders, including the IBEA, to ensure that the new authority meets the needs of learners and job seekers.